medalist, their son also gold medalist, and he got the best job. Everything was best, you know. But then where is the problem, you know? Then you wait for that. There's no spice in that. Never, it is spiceless. So actually God has built in all these problems to provide spice in the life, otherwise you will get bored with that also, really. You keep on eating sweets and sweets and sweets and sweets, and it's like, enough now, I don't want. Give me some chutney, give me some pickle. Of course you can't eat pickles all the time also, but therefore, so you must have a spice in there, some plot must be there, some unpredictability there, some challenge must be there. Whether you want it or not, it is there. The point is, you may say, I don't want challenges, but it is there anyway. Some people say, I don't want it. Alright, even if you don't want it is there, and therefore, you better be ready for it. I'm not ready for it. Doesn't matter. If you're not ready, then you'll have to become ready. They'll make you ready anyway. So, that is how the life is. They'll keep on thrashing you and molding you until you become ready for it. That's what it is. Regardless of that, I don't know. The point is, this samsaritva, samsaritvam, all these contradictory things are, is it that any designation comes only because there is a situation, there is a problem, there is a reference. With reference to that, which is what we call upadhi, there is a certain designation or a certain concept with reference to paramatma. So this tatha hiranyagarbhatvam buddhipadissayavadu tamasattva rajayogad yati kshetrajnyatamajah tatha hiranyagarbhatvam buddhipadihi. He himself explains why it's called sakshi. Sakshi is chidavasa vishishta avidyopadihi sakshitvam. Why it's called antaryami? Says maya tatkarya nendratvena antaryamita. Then why is he called hiranyagarbha? So, tasyeva mayamaya apanchikrita bhuta panchaka arabdha samasti buddhipaditvena jnana shaktivata hiranyagarbhatvam. Hiranyagarbha is what? Mayamaya apanchikrita, when the five elements are not yet crucified. Apanchikrita bhuta panchaka arabdha, the five elements in their subtle state. Samasti buddhipaditvena, samasti buddhi, which is a product of the apanchikrita panchamaha bhuta, the same paramatma. When he has his samasti, buddhi as a upadhi, then it's called hiranyagarbha. Jnana shakti madha. Kriya shakti madha, pranaha, jnana shakti madha, hiranyagarbha. Hiranyagarbhatvam. And then, tamas sattva rajo yoga, same hiranyagarbha by the association with tamaha, sattva and rajas. This upadhi, individual upadhi. He's called what? Kshetrajna dhamaja, he's called kshetrajna. So kshetram janati. What is kshetram? Sattva, rajas and tamas. He is called kshetrajna because he is a knower of this kshetra. Okay. Then continuing further. Tasseva samasti pranopadehe kriya shakti madha sutratvam. He is called sutra or prana. Again. Samasti pranopadehe. So when it's samasti buddhi upadhi, there is jnana shakti, ichha shakti and kriya shakti. Therefore, paramatma endowed with the totality of jnana and ichha shakti is called hiranyagarbha. When endowed with the totality of kriya shakti is called sutra or prana. The seva samasti prana upadhi kriya shakti madha sutra tvam. When it is endowed with the samasti prana, meaning kriya shakti, then it is called sutra. Tasseva panchikrita bhuta panchaka arabdha samasti upadehe viratvam. Again, when he is endowed with the gross totality of all the gross bodies made of the five gross elements, he is called virat. Tasseva prakrita bhuta arabdha sattvika rajasa tamasa vyashti buddhi upadhi sambandhat nana jiva rupata. Again, when as this creation, you know, unfolds further and further from the subtler to the gross, so the subtlest is Chidavasa Vishishtatvam, then Antaryamitvam, then Hiranyagarbhatvam, then Pranatvam, then Viratvam, and then Jivatvam. This is how the same Brahma manifests at all these different layers of manifestation. Tasseva Prakrata Bhuta, mean what? Panchikrata, Panchamahabhuta Arabdha, Sattvika, Rajasa, Tamasa, Vyashti Buddhi. Then we have the Vyashti Buddhi. समष्टि बुद्धि एसेंशियली विशुद्ध सत्व हिरण्यगर्भ इज एंडोर्ड विशुद्ध सत्व बुद्धि बट देन व्हेन द ग्रॉसिफिकेशन टेक्स प्लेस देन ऑल दिस रजस तमस आल्सो मैनिफेस्ट इन देयर एंड देन समष्टि बुद्धि इज दैट विच एंडोर्ड विद दिस सत्व रजस एंड तमस आई मीन व्यष्टि बुद्धि इज एंडोर्ड विद सत्व रजस एंड तमस एंड सेम परमात्मा आइडेंटिफाइड विद दिस व्यष्टि बुद्धि इज कॉल्ड जीवा And since these buddhis are many, therefore jivas are also many. Since samashti buddhi is one, Hiranyagarbha is one, and vyashti buddhis are many, then same Paramatma is called many, with reference to the jivas. So, nana jiva rupadayate abhipretyah tamahiti. Tamas sattva rajo yogad yati kshetrajnyatam ajah. This ajah. This ajah means unborn kshetrajnyatam yati. He comes to be designated as Kshatrajna on account of identification or association with the Vyashti or the individual Upadhi, which is of the nature of Sattva, Rajas and Tamas. Viruddhartha Vachasam Ekadra Sambhavam Upasamharati. So how these contradictory Vakyas have Ekatra Sambhavam, how both of them are possible in one Paramatma Upasamharati, which is Vardhikara. अभिन्न बुद्ध्या भिन्नत्वं भिन्न जीविश्च भिन्नताम इति चित् स्वतमोहे मोहेतोः इति चित् स्वत स्वतमोहेतोः न किञ्चिदपि दुःस्थितम् इति अभिन्न बुद्ध्या अभिन्नत्वं दैट्स ऑल अभिन्न बुद्धि ही इज अभिन्न भिन्न जीविश्च भिन्नताम सो देयरफॉर सर्वभूतेषु येनैकं भावमव्ययमीक्षते अभिभक्तम विभक्तेषु सज्ञानम विद्धि सात्विकम देखो सात्विकम ज्ञानम अभिभक्तम विभक्तेषु सो इन एंड थ्रू द डिवाइडेड वन हु सीज इंडिविजुअल सर्वभूतेषु येन एकम भावम अव्ययम ईक्षते दैट नॉलेज बाय विच वन परसीव्स और वन अप्रिशिएट्स एक भाव और दैट वन रियलिटी इन एंड थ्रू ऑल द बीइंग्स द अनडिवाइडेड इन एंड थ्रू द डिवाइडेड दैट नॉलेज इज कॉल्ड सात्विकम ज्ञानम So therefore here says Vartikara Abhinna buddhya abhinnatvam So why that buddhi or that knowledge which is sattvika then one appreciates the Paramatma as abhinna meaning as undivided Bhinna dhivishcha bhinnatam Whereas prasaktvena tu yajnanam nana bhavan prasakvidan vithi sarveshu bhuteshu tajnanam vidhirajasam Whereas one who sees, because the beings are all different, when one sees them all as different beings, then that knowledge is called Rajasam. So when you have this Bhedati, then the Jnanam, then same Paramatma also is Bhinna or divided. When you have Abhedati, then same Paramatma is appreciated as undivided. Iti Chit Sotamo Hetoho Oh, it is chit. Svatamo hetoho na kinchidabhi dusthitim. It is, what is it? Yeah, what is it? Chit sva. Acha, chit. It is chit. Yeah, this is. Svatamoheto, this is a thing here, okay. Iti chit, in this manner, chit means the consciousness, svatamoheto ho. Svatamoheto meaning because of the ignorance, which is the Yeah. Iti chit bhinnatam abhinnatvam eti svatamoheto ho. Because of the hetu in the sense of sva. And svatamo hetoho from its own standpoint or from the standpoint of tamas or ignorance the same chit or the awareness can be called abhinnata abhinna from its own standpoint tamo hetoho meaning from the standpoint of the ignorance the same one can be called bhinna or divided na kinchidapi dusthitim see how he compresses everything svatamo hetoho svahetoho tamo hetoho from the standpoint of itself Abhinnatama and Tamo Heto from standpoint of ignorance, सेम परमात्मा इज सीन एज डिवाइडेड न किंचित अभी दुस्थितिम देयरफॉर ऑल एज फार एज दिस स्टेटमेंट्स आर कंसर्न्ड देयर इज नो दुस्थिति मीनिंग देयर इज नो कॉन्ट्रडिक्शन और देयर इज नो अनसेटलमेंट एट ऑल दिस स्टेटमेंट्स आर ऑल राइट डिपेंडिंग अपॉन हाउ शुड यू लिसन टू दिस स्टेटमेंट्स डिपेंडिंग अपॉन अ गिवन स्टैंड पॉइंट स्वहेतु हो और तमोहेतु हो पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणम् सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः हरिः ॐ श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ॐ पेज 173 रीड मंत्र अतेत्यभ्यमन्थत समुखा च योनेर्हस्ताभ्यां च अग्निमसृजत इज दिस मंत्र वी सपोज टू रीड एतदुभयम् अलोमकमन्तरतः अलोमका हि योनिः अन्तरतः तद्यदिदमाहुः अमुं यज अमुं यजेति एकैकं देवम् एतस्यैव सा विसृष्टिः एषह्येव सर्वे देवाः अथ यत्किञ्च इदमार्द्रम् तद्रेतसः असृजत तदु सोमः एतावद्वा इदं सर्वम् अन्नं चैव अन्नादश्च सोम एवान्नम् अग्निरन्नादः सैषा ब्रह्मणोति सृष्टिः यच्छ्रेयसो देवा न सृजत असयन्मर्त्यः सन् अमृता न सृजत तस्मादतिसृष्टिः अतिसृष्ट्यां ह अस्य एतस्यां भवति य एवं वेद Here the creation of what is known as Anugrahaka. The earlier mantras describe the creation of Anugrahya, creation of the Praja, the Brahmanas, Kshatriya and all this. This mantra describes the creation of Anugrahaka, the Devatas. It is said how Prajapati created fire from his mouth by churning with his hands, and that is how the fire is created. So fire is the presiding deity of Brahmanas, and then Bhashyakara says that we should also understand that rest of the Devatas are also created, which preside over the other, the caste like Kshatriyas, etc. Then also followed the Ninda of the view that the Devatas are many. That even though the fact is that Prajapati alone is all the Devatas, because from him alone are Devatas created, and still those who believe the Devatas are many, and therefore they say, Tadyadidam Ahuhu, amamyaja amamyajati. That when this pure karmakanda is, meaning the karma, the people who believe that karmakanda is, karma is the ultimate means in life, and therefore they keep on saying this, that worship this, worship this. Ekaikam devam, they say that individual devatas are different from one another. That is not so. Tanna adaraniyam, that should not be respected, meaning the mumukshus should not accept that. Although it is fine for the karmakandis and as much as for anyone who wants to worship, it is fine. But then for the one who is searching for the truth, that one should not accept that as the ultimate view. Etasya evasa visrushtihi, because this whole creation is of Prajapati himself. Eshau hyev sarve devaha, because this Prajapati indeed are all the devatas, and therefore those individual devatas are not to be taken as separate from one another. So this is how the creation of Agni or the fire was described, and this much we discussed. Now we are going to proceed to discuss further. Asa yat kinchaidam ardram tadretasah srujata. Now subsequently is going to describe the creation of Soma, the moon. It will be said here that the fire is annadaha, the eater of the food, and the Soma or the moon is annam, meaning the food itself. And thus the whole creation consists of the food and the eater of the food, anna and annada. This is indeed the creation. So wherever food is, know that to be Soma, and wherever the eater of food is, know that to be fire. And this is all the creation is. And this is being told to us for the purpose of meditation upon the creation, as to how Prajapati has manifest himself in the form of these two principles, the food and the eater of food. And one who meditates thus also becomes like Prajapati, is able to create an excellent srishti. Now, going back to page 180, where we started discussion in the last session. Bhashyakara had raised a Purupaksha, in fact two Purupakshas were raised. Is one paksha which says that Prajapati is para, meaning is Paramatma. Other Purupaksha says Prajapati is a samsari. And there are Shruti and the Smriti quotations to support both these views. Indram Mitram Varanam Agnimahuhu iti Esha Brahma Esha Indra Esha Prajapati Ete Sarve Devaha iti cha Shrutehe. So the Shruti say, one was from Rigveda, other is from Maitreya Upanishad, where it is said that this Prajapati indeed is all the devatas, or what is Prajapati is nothing but this Paramatma. Smriti also says, Etameke Vadantyagnim Manumanye Prajapatim. This Paramatma alone is called Agni Manu Prajapati, and therefore the one who is called Prajapati here is none other than Paramatma, Param Brahma. This is one view. Samsari vasyat, other view is that no, this Prajapati should be taken as samsari. Sarvan papmanah aushada, right, this Upanishad itself says that this Yajamana became the Prajapati by burning all his sins. And nahi asamsarinah papmadah prasangahasti. If Prajapati was a samsari to begin with, then there was no question of his burning the sins. The fact that he had to burn the sins means he was afflicted by the sins, means he was samsari, and therefore he is samsari. Bhaya arati sanyoga shravanacha. So bibhed, Prajapati also had fear. Sanayvareme, that he was not happy. All of this cannot be associated with Lord or Paramatma. Therefore also we say that Prajapati is a jiva. Athayan martyasan amritan asrujata. This Upanishad, this mantra itself says that Prajapati, being a mortal, created all the immortal devatas. So this itself describes Prajapati as Martyah. Hiranyagarbham pashyati jayamanam. Also another Shruti says that this Paramatma sees Hiranyagarbha, who is being born. So Hiranyagarbha is the one who has birth. So not only is Martyah, meaning possessed of death, but pashyati jayamanam is also endowed with birth. So Hiranyagarbha or Prajapati is the one who is endowed with birth and death, therefore is jiva. Smriteshya, and the Smriti also says that as a result of the excellent, as an excellent result of karma and the upasana, one can attain the state of Brahma, etc. And so All of these Shrutis and Smritis seem to clearly indicate that Prajapati is a Jiva. Both become Purupakshas, inasmuch as each one believes this alone to be true. So Vedantin says both are okay. That is the Siddhanta. Therefore both become Purupaksha. So each one is right, but then both of them are right from a given standpoint. Therefore not only one of them is right, both of them are right. So on the page 180, Athevam Viruddhartha Anupattehe Pramanya Vyaghata Hiti Chet. This is how the Purupakshis concluded that Purupaksha. Athevam, in this manner, Viruddhartha Anupattehe. From the Shruti and the Smritis, we learn the contradictory meaning that Samsayat Prajapati is Paramatma and is Jiva. This kind of contradictory conclusions we arrive at from the Shruti and the Smritis. Pramanya Vyagadaha, we cannot call them Pramana. Pramana cannot give you contradictory data, you know, otherwise not Pramana. So I says that this is yellow and it is black, you don't wonder, you know. So this is yellow as well as black. So if I say one object alone is yellow and black, then we have to question its pramanyam. Unless the object happens to be yellow and black, both of course. But one object cannot be two things. You know, one thing cannot be two contradictory. And therefore, if the Shrutis and Smritis, which are accepted as pramanam, they say that Prajapati is Paramatma as well as Jiva, then they cannot be considered as pramanam. Iti chet, this is what you have to say. Then we said na, that is not so. Kalpanantaropattehe avirodhat. That kalpanantaropattehe. Both of these kalpanas are upanna, meaning both of them are tenable. Upadi vishesh sambandhat vishesh kalpanantaram upapadyate. Same vaki is explained. Upadi vishesh sambandhat. On account of sambandha or association with upadi, vishesh kalpanantaram upapadyate. That Prajapati can be even considered as samsari on account of his association with upadi. Therefore, that kalpana or that position also is tenable. That Prajapati is samsari, and that Prajapati from his own standpoint, from Swarupa, is Param Brahma, also is quite right. And this is what the Vedantin has to say. With reference to this, we also read the Karika, rather Vartika, of Sureshwaracharya. And now we go back to Bhashya, where Vatikara said in this conclusion that eti chit svatamo hetoho na kinchit vidusthitam dusthitamiti abhinna buddhya abhinnatvam bhinnadhi bhischa bhinnatam bhinnadhi bhischa bhinnatam eti chit svatamo hetoho na kinchit vidusthitam iti abhinna buddhya abhinnatvam. That when you look upon by abhinna buddhi, then all the devatas are one alone. Bhinnadhi vischa bhinnatam. On the other hand, if you look at from the upadhi standpoint, then all of them are different. So bhinna chit eti, chit abhinnatvam eti, chit bhinnatam eti. Chit meaning same Brahmatma, the consciousness that attains the state of abhinnata, meaning oneness, or bhinnatameti, or attain the state of manyness, depending upon how you look upon that. So how we look upon chit or awareness of Paramatma, then same Paramatma can be looked upon as many or can be looked upon as one. Naturally, when is many, then each one is limited and therefore each one will become Jiva. When is one, then naturally he is free from limitations and he is Paramatma. Svatamo hetoho. Sva meaning from his own standpoint, from the standpoint of Swarupa, ekatameti, and tamohetoho from the standpoint of ignorance, bhinnatameti. This is how we have to see. This was the nirnaya given by Vatikakara, and this is what Vashyakara also says now. Anandagiri says in the third line, Svatah asamsaritvam kalpanayaca samsaritvam iti kalpanantara sambhavat. Svatah asamsaritvam, from the standpoint of the Swarupa, asamsaritvam, Kalpanaya meaning from the standpoint of the upadhi or association with the upadhi, regardless of what the upadhi is always going to be limited. The moment it becomes manifest, it becomes limited. And therefore, Ishvara is the one endowed with the upadhi that is unmanifest with infinite potential. But the moment it gets manifest as even Hiranyagarbha, Prajapati, there is some kind of liberation. From that standpoint, you may say that there is a limitation. From the standpoint of Swarupa, however, it is limitless. Idi kalpanandra sambhavat dvividha shrutinam avirodhat pramanya siddhihi. That both the shrutis, they are not contradictory. When one shruti talks about the jivatma of Prajapati, that is from the standpoint of upadhi. When the other shruti says Prajapati is limitless, that is from his own Swarupa, and therefore they are not opposed to each other. Kalpanaya samsaritvam iti etat visayadeti upadhi vishesh sambandhat. That only it is kalpana because of which that Prajapati or anyone is looked upon as samsari, that samsaritvam itself is kalpana. And so that is what Bhashyakara said, upadhi vishesh sambandhat vishesh kalpanantaram upapadyate. So as we said, on account of association with upadhi, that we can even see how Paramatma also can be looked upon as a samsari. Now, continuing, says Anandagiri, Aupadhigi parasya vishesha kalpana iti yatra pramanamaha. Aupadhigi parasya vishesha kalpana, parasya of Paramatma, vishesha kalpana meaning samsaritva kalpana, aupadhigi. That Paramatma is samsari is purely on the standpoint of, from the standpoint of upadhi. Iti yatra pramanamaha. For that, the pramanam meaning is mantra from Kathopanishad stated here by Bhashyakara. Asino duram vrajati shayano yati sarvatah kastam madamadam devam madanyo jnatumarhati. About this Atma, it is said, Asinaha Duram Vrajati. Asinaha, one is sitting. Duram Vrajati, while sitting, he goes far. Shayanaha Yati Sarvataha. Shayanaha, while sleeping, Yati Sarvataha. He goes everywhere. While sitting, he goes far. While sleeping, he goes everywhere. Kastam Madamadam Devam. This Devata is what? Madamadam. Mada means harsha, amada means aharsha. So this devata meaning atma devata is endowed with mada and amada. Mada means intoxication. Amada means lack of it. So the devata who is, you know, who experiences harsha and freedom from harsha, kastam that devata madanyaha kam tam jnatumarhati. Other than me, Yamaraja says to Nachiketa, other than me, who can know this devata? Meaning other than someone like us, who is endowed with these qualifications, who have the sukshma buddhi, who have the sadhana chatushtaya sampatti, other than us, who can see this devata, who is endowed with these contradictory characteristics? You can't handle it. You can't, you know, you cannot arrive at any single idea about it. Moment you arrive at it, there is a contradictory idea. And therefore, it cannot become an object of an idea. That's the whole idea, you know, that it cannot become an object of an idea. You can't idealize it, visualize it, so confine it to some kind of a kalpana. When the mind becomes like that, then alone that mind can know. So when we talk of the sadhana, yogyata, etc., it is a particular kind of mind. How else to talk about it? So when the Vedantic teachers talk about the qualification, it talks about a certain kind of a mind. Naturally, that mind has to be one who is free from other janjal, you know, samsara, meaning, therefore it has the vairagya. But apart from that, it has the ability to penetrate through this pair of contradictions and then see the thing as a whole. So mind, that is the ability to see the whole without having to compartmentalize the things.
without having to judge a thing, only from a given, come to a certain conclusion about it. So that kind of mind that only judges and concludes, that mind is not capable of seeing truth which is whole, devoid of all judgments and true conclusions. So, madanyaha kastam jnatum arhati, other than me or other than us, who can know that? Understand, in our life also, moment we come to conclusions, judgments and stuff like that, we are entertaining a mind which is like that. Of course, you may say that for vyavahara all of that is to be done, but you have to be therefore very careful that you don't get drawn so much to vyavahara that it dictates you completely, that it colors, you know. And some fellows should not get so engrossed with this that if vyavahara becomes thoroughly useless, but that is okay. That may be okay, but then person who is so vyavahar kushala will never be able to, handle this. They say that the wise man can handle this as well as that, okay. But if somebody cannot handle that, handles this, that is okay. Impractical person you may call him, but that is okay. But the so-called practical person who always has to see things and conclude, well, it is that mind which is a samsari mind, in the sense that the mind can only see one aspect at a time, and therefore cannot comprehend that a thing can have multi aspects or infinite aspects here. Anyway, now here the problem is, the quotation is Asinaha Duram Vrajati Shayanaha Sarvatahayati. This is the idea here. Asinaha, while sitting, Duram Vrajati, he goes far. Anandaka explains that Swarasthena Kutasthobhyatma Manasaha Shigram Durgamana Darshanat Tadupadiko Duram Vrajati. Asinaha, meaning sitting, Swarasthena, from his own standpoint, meaning from the standpoint of his Swarupa. Kutasthobhyatma, he is seated, means he is kutastha, changeless. Manasaha shigram duragamana darshanat, however, on account of identification with the mind, which mind can go from one place to the other, mind can be here and by the sankalpa, mind can be away. So, manasaha shigram duragamana darshanat, we find that the mind goes far away with its sankalpa. Tat upadikaha, the one identified with the mind, upadikaha duram vrajati, that atma identified with the mind goes far away. This is his glory. What baffles us happens to his glory, and that is the thing, that this is baffling. How can he, and this is simultaneous, understand? See, the grammar here says asinaha duram vrajati. While he is seated, he goes far. So you want to compartmentalize either this or that, that becomes difficult. Therefore he says, asinaha duram vrajati. So while seated, he goes far. So while remaining kutastha, you may say, he appears to be going far. That's what the Vedantins will add. Asinaha, while really being seated, meaning being changeless, duram vrajati, he appears to be going far. So whenever we find these contradictions obtaining in one locus, then we know that one of them has to be mithya. So asinaha swarasena, from his own standpoint, meaning from the standpoint, from his swarupa, kutastaha, he is changeless. But then manasaha duragamana darshanat, since the mind, we find that the mind goes far and far away, tadupadikaha, the one who is identified with the mind, appears to be going away. That also is okay. So for Vedanta, everything is okay, ultimate. See, this is Vairagya. Vairagya is not everything is wrong, but Vairagya is everything is okay here. Asina is also okay, Duram Vrajati also okay. That is a real Vairagya. If you don't accept Duram Vrajati, that means there is Dvesha there, So Vairagya means there is no Dvesha and no Raga. Thereby he says here. So Duram Vrajati also is okay. Asina is of course perfect, but Duram Vrajati also is okay. So really this word mithya makes everything okay. On one hand you may say word mithya seems to dismiss everything. That's what people feel. On the other hand, word mithya makes everything is fine. This also is okay. Why not? So this also is okay. Shayano yati sarvatah. So shayanaha yatha svapne shayano api manasaha gadi bhrantya sarvatriyati ubhati जागरेपि इत्यर्थः यथा स्वप्ने शयानोपि. फुटनोट नंबर 7. अचलः यथा स्वप्ने अचलः. In fact, Shayanaha means sleeping. Sleeping also is understood only as Kutastha. But then with reference, sleeping means one who is not awake or one who is not dreaming, that is what we call. You see, yatra na kanchana kamam kamayate na kanchana svapnam pashyati tat susuptam. Where there is no kama and when there is no svapna, that is called susupti. That is how atma can be called susuptaha. Shayana means where there is no kamana meaning jagratavastha or svapna meaning svapnavastha, where none of this is there, you can call it susupti. And so atma can be called sleeping in that stand, from the, in that manner he can be called sleeping, in as much as a sleeping person neither desires nor does he project any dream, and so also there is no desire nor any dream in atma, that way we can call him Shayana. But yati sarvadaha, he goes everywhere, meaning as in dream the mind projects everything, and you can say he alone projects. Who does all this? That's also a problem. Who goes everywhere? You cannot say that the mind goes everywhere, because mind is inert. So inert thing cannot go everywhere. Only a conscious being can go everywhere, and therefore you have to say again that he alone goes everywhere. So the frustrating thing for the people is that they would so much like to see that certain things are not there, that they are wrong, or they are not existent. So recently I received a letter, Swamiji, where is this Krishna? Where is God? There is the politics is like this and people are suffering, and it is true also. Everywhere in the world people are suffering. Where is God? We want to look for God, but we don't find anywhere. So there is so much frustration and pain in there, which is alright, pain is okay. But frustration is not okay. If pain out of frustration is one thing, pain out of compassion is another thing, understand? But most people have frustration. Frustration is because we like to see certain things and we don't see Him. We like to see Krishna and we don't see Him, or what we see is not Krishna, and therefore there is this frustration. And frustrated mind cannot proceed further, you know. You have to release that mind anyway, somehow. That's how the Mithya helps you always, by showing that, well, this also is okay, that also is okay. So mind just gets locked up with certain things, you know, for days it goes on like that. And you just have to prick in one way, then it gets released, okay, that's alright. But the thing is, that this also is okay, that also is okay, not in vyavahara, but in understanding it is okay. If a vyavahara is spontaneous, well, that also is okay. But shayana means one who is free from any dream or the desire. Yati sarvataha, he goes everywhere. In the sleep also one goes everywhere, in as much as in sleep there is no identification with any body or any personality, and therefore that sleep is a state which is all pervasive. In that sense also one can say that while sleeping one goes everywhere. Or yatha svapne shayano bhi, while svapne jagare bhi, shayana hai, atma is always sleeping, in the sense that he is free from the dream and the desire. Manasaha gati bhrantya sarvatrayati bhadi. But then because of the gati bhranti, because of the mind, there is bhranti or the delusion that the mind goes everywhere, and that also doesn't go anywhere. They say that the mind also does not go any place, that also remains only within the body. So idea there is that if the mind goes away from the body, then the body cannot survive. And therefore, the fact that the body is alive shows that the mind or the subtle body is within the body. And if we feel that we go all kinds into all kinds of places, that also is sankalpa, which is also a bhranti. I went to Rishikesh and Vrindavan and all kinds of places, you know, while. So that also is nothing but the sankalpa of the mind. But it is so real that we feel that we are there, you know. That is the different matter. But otherwise it's nothing but the sankalpa of the mind. So manasaha gati bhranti, the gati of the mind also is a bhranti, you know. Sarvatra yati eva bhati. And so it looks as though mind goes everywhere and the atma also goes. Sadhihi svapno bhutva. On account of identification of the mind, svapno bhutva, it becomes a dreamer, meaning becomes dream and seems to go everywhere. Tatha jagarebi, in the waking state also atma is sleeping, meaning he is a witness. Then also atma seems to be going everywhere. Yad jagrato durumudaiti. Yadu suptasya tathaivaiti. While awake, goes everywhere. Sleeping, comes back where he was. So this is how the contradictions are there. It is not that the Shruti wants to confuse us and therefore tells us contradictory things. The Pramanam is not that it is trying to confuse us by telling contradictory things, but contradictions obtain in life. What will you do about it? Since contradictions obtain the life, and since if you just take any one paksha, then you will be wrong, meaning it will be partial, which is taken as a whole. So the Shruti really wants us to come out of this hanging on to any one paksha. And that is how the mind can have the vision of the whole, or can see the part as a part. That's the reason why we find the Shruti or the Smriti, which are Pramanas, we find them also telling apparently contradictory things. Not because they are telling us contradictory things, because contradictions obtain in life. So in fact, the Shastra is explaining the contradictions rather than creating contradictions. We think that the Shastra is creating contradiction in our mind. Matsani sarabhudani, nachaham teshu avastita, nacha matsani bhudani. The same breath. And therefore, what is it? Nirgunam guna bhoktruca, asaktam sarabhrutchaiva, nirgunam guna bhoktruca. And all of these are contradictory, but that is exactly how life is. Life is full of contradictions in that sense. Except that one part is mithya, other part is satya, and this is how we have to understand. This is what really scriptures want to explain to us, and that is how they appear to be talking in the language of contradictions or paradoxes and whatever. Kastam madamadam, Anandagiri explains that kalpitena harshadi vikarena swabhavikena tadabhavena cha mada amadam devam. Mada means harsha, so kalpitena harshadi vikarena. There seems to be harshadi vikara in the atma. Atma is hrushtaha. He is overjoyed, you know. Svabhavikena tadabhavena cha. In reality, he is devoid of harsha or shoka or any kind of reactions. But in vyavahara, appears to be full of these reactions and avegas. So that is kalpana. And svabhavikena tadabhavena cha. In reality, atma is devoid of the harsha, shoka, all these reactions. Yuktam atmanam na kaschidapi nischedum shaknodi. Therefore, atma such as that, no one can ever arrive at any nischay as to exactly how he is. So, that is what? It is not that Yamaraja is proudly claiming himself to be adhikari and dismissing others as not. He is saying something by that. Nischedum na kaschidapi nischedum shaknodi. No one can really arrive at a final conclusion about the Atma. That is what Yamaraja means to say. Kastam madamadam devam madanyo jnatumarhati. Who other than me, meaning who other than us, who are qualified, can ever know the Self? Ityevam adishrutibhya. Adishabdena adipadena dhyayati eva ityadi shrutayah grihyante. So dhyayati eva for a change, Vashyaka has quoted a different mantra. Every time he quotes only one mantra. Dhyayati eva, lelayati eva. There are many mantras, but somehow that seems to be there in his mind every time. And so here, at least another mantra has been found. In commenting upon this mantra, he will quote that mantra anyway. Dhyayati eva, lelayati eva. But at least another mantra is found here. Okay, now, Udaharata Shrutinam Tatparimaha. The Shrutis which were quoted by the Purapakshis earlier, Tatparimaha. What is the Tatparya? The contradictory sounding Shrutis and Smritis. What is the Tatparya, the purport of them? That is what Bhashyakara is Upadhiti. Upadhivashat Samsaritvam Na Paramarthataha Svatah asamsaryeva evam ekatvam nanatvam cha hiranyagarbhasya. Upadivashat samsaritvam. From this time down, upadi hiranyagarbha is samsari. न परमार्थतः बट हिरण्यगर्भ इज नॉट संसारी परमार्थतः इन रियालिटी ही इज नॉट संसारी किम तरही पारमार्थिकः पारमार्थिकम तदाह ऑल राइट व्हाट इज अल्टीमेट देन सुभाषकरण स्वतः असंसारेव ऑल राइट इज संसारित्वं पारमार्थिकम और असंसारित्वं पारमार्थिक व्हाट इज पारमार्थिक इफ प्रजापति संसारी फ्रॉम वन स्टैंड पॉइंट असंसारी फ्रॉम अनदर स्टैंड पॉइंट व्हाट इज अल्टीमेट थिंग स्वतः असंसारेव इन रियालिटी फ्रॉम हिज ओन स्टैंड पॉइंट मीनिंग From the Swarupa, from as his Swarupa is concerned, he is a samsari alone. Hiranyagarbhasya vastavam avastavam. Hiranyagarbha. And there is also another aspect which is unreal. Vastavam avastavam rupam. निरूपितम् उपसंहरति देन नौ भाष्यकर सहित एवं न एकत्वम् नानात्वम् च हिरण्यगर्भस्य एवं इन दिस मैनर हिरण्यगर्भस्य एकत्वम् हिरण्यगर्भस्य हिरण्यगर्भ इज वन इन रियलिटी नानात्वम् च मेनीनेस फ्रॉम द स्टैंड पॉइंट उपाधि हिरण्यगर्भ इज वन फ्रॉम द स्टैंड फ्रॉम द इन रियलिटी द रियलिटी कैन नॉट अ स्टैंड पॉइंट बाय द वे सो वी शुड नॉट से फ्रॉम द स्टैंड पॉइंट ऑफ रियलिटी In reality, Hiranyagarbha is one. From the standpoint of Upadhi, he appears as many. Then Anandagiri continues, Tasyapi asmadadivat na svataha brahmatvam kintu samsaritvam eva svabhavikamiti ashankya. Well, if Hiranyagarbha is both samsari and asamsari, then like us, Asmadadivat na svataha brahmatvam. We are not brahma, definitely we are samsaris. So svataha, that we are by nature samsari. And so samsaritvam eva svabhavikam. Just as we from our own, from the reality or from svabhava are samsaris, so also one may say that Hiranyagarbha is a samsari by his nature. Iti ashankya drishtantasya sadhya vikalatamaha tatha iti. So, drishtantasya sadhya vikaltam aha. Tatha sarva jivanam. Okay. Drishtanta is an interesting. Asmadadivat. But where is that? Oh, that is his own drishtanta. Acha. Tasyapi asmadadivat. Anandagiri drishtanta. Okay. Tasyapi asmadadivat na svataha brahmatvam. Okay. I mean, so Anandagiri himself said, I was looking in the Bhashya. Asmadadivat. So Anandagiri said, like us, Hiranyagarbha also is a samsari. So we become the drishtanta of Hiranyagarbha. He says, no. Drishtantasya sadhya vikaltamaha. Even you also are not samsari. Idea is, that is that, If you say that Hiranyagarbha is like us, well, even us also are not samsari. So, tatha, sadhya vikalatam aha. Vikalata means sadhya rahityam, that even in drishtanta, namely asmadadivat, in people like us, that we are, how we are samsaris by svabhava, then Hiranyagarbha also is samsari, that now, even you also not samsari by svabhava. If drishtanta can be proven, then the dashtanta can be proven. But even the jivas are also not samsari by svabhava, then what to talk of Hiranyagarbha not being samsari? Vashyakara says, Tatha sarva jivanam tatvamase iti shrutehe Tatha sarva jivanam ekatvam nanatvam cha Ekatvam, Svataha, Nanatvam, Upadhitaha. That jivas also are many because of, from the standpoint of Upadhi. and jivas are also one or para from by their own swarupa, the nature. Sarva jivanam ekatvam nanatvam chaiti purvena sambandha. Tesham svataha brahmatve pramanama. In short, the jivas are also brahma. In reality, pramanama tatvamasi iti shrutehe. This is what the shruti says. Tat meaning brahma. So jiva is none other than brahma. Alright, so both are the same. We and Hiranyagarbha are in the same category. Hiranyagarbha also is a samsari in reality, samsari by upadhi. We are also a samsari in reality, samsari by upadhi. So what's the difference? Hiranyagarbha and we, both of them seem to be the same category. So Anandagiri says, Kastari Hiranyagarbha Vishesha. Alright, what is then so different about Hiranyagarbha? Yena asau asmadadavi upasate. We are being asked to worship Hiranyagarbha. So there has to be some difference between us and Hiranyagarbha. Kastari Hiranyagarbha Visheshaha. What is so special about Hiranyagarbha that we are being, or he becomes the Upasya, or he becomes one who is worshipped by us, and definitely therefore Hiranyagarbha and we are not same in every way. So what is the Vishesha there? Tatraha Hiranyagarbhastu iti. Bhashyakara says Hiranyagarbhastu. Hiranyagarbhastu upadhi shuddhyadishaya pekshaya prayashaha para eveti shruti smriti vada pravrittaha samsaritvam tu vachideva darshayanti jivanantu upadigata ashuddha ashuddhi bahulyat samsaritvameva prayashah abhilapyade. Hiranyagarbhastu upadhi shuddhi atishay apekshaya. Inasmuch as the upadhi of Hiranyagarbha is exceedingly pure, some little impurity is there, therefore we sometimes see some limitations there, but essentially Hiranyagarbha is endowed with an excellent upadhi, exceedingly pure upadhi. Therefore paap manaha aushada, that is how he burned all the sins, and that is how he has purified the upadhi. Prayashaha para eva iti shruti smriti vadaha pravrittaha. Therefore prayashaha in majority of the cases, or more often than not, the Shruti and the Smritis describe Hiranyagarbha as Param, as Ishvara. Prayashaha says footnote number 1, Bhayaratyadi samsara pratitistu kadachideva srishtyadi kale iti uktum prayashaha iti. Although this Shruti herself here says that Hiranyagarbha was endowed with fear and arati, but that is something rare, and generally we find the Shruti and the Smritis describing Hiranyagarbha as is Ishvara, as limitless. Iti shruti smriti vadaha pravrittaha, says again footnote number 2, Hiranyagarbhasya paratva bodhakaha purvoktaha. Earlier shrutis and smritis that were quoted here describing the limitlessness or paratva of Hiranyagarbha, they are the majority of the shrutis and smritis, and now and then, as in this case here, you find a statement which seems to describe Prajapati as a samsari. Samsaritvam tu kvachideva darshayanti. The shrutis and smritis do seem to show samsaritvam of Hiranyagarbha or Prajapati kvachid, in some occasion only. That's why Anandagiri said, nanu shruti smriti vadeshu kvachit tasya samsaritvam api pradashyate satyam. Okay, sometimes we do find the samsaritvam of Hiranyagarbha. Now and then, satyam okay, tattu kalpitam iti abhipretya. That is again only from the standpoint of upadhi, and therefore samsaritvam is kalpitam. Samsaritvam of Hiranyagarbha is something that is imagined or projected or superimposed, and not that which is in reality there. Samsaritvam tu kvachideva darshayanti. So after pravrittaha, there should be a comma rather than a full stop. Samsaritvam tu kvachideva darshayanti. Asmadadishu api tulyam etaditya asankyaha. Oh, that looks the same. Hiranyagarbha and we appear to be same again. So we are all samsari now and then and pure generally. He says, no. Jivanam tu upadigata ashuddhi bahulyat. So the jiva upadhi said to be malina sattva pradhana. The upadhi of Hiranyagarbha is vishuddha sattva pradhana prakritihi. And here upadhi of jiva is malina sattva pradhana. Where the sattva is overwhelmed by rajas and tamas. In case of Hiranyagarbha, sattva is a predominant guna. That is the difference. And therefore, again, that's how Panchadashikara describe Hiranyagarbha and the jiva like this. That upadhi of Hiranyagarbha and upadhi of jiva, both of them are reflections of one prakriti. Or they are only one modification of one prakriti. So he called one prakriti as the original substance. And this Vishuddha Sattva Pradhana Prakriti, he was called Maya. Malina Sattva Pradhana Prakriti was called Avidya. And Tamah Pradhana Prakriti was called Jagat. So one Prakriti alone manifests as Ishvara, Jiva and Jagat. When that Prakriti, there is predominance of Sattva, we call it Maya. Where is Sarvajnyatvam, Sarvashaktimatvam, whatever. When there is in that Prakriti predominance of Rajas and Tamas or ignorance, we call it Jiva Agnyanam. Where there is predominance of Alpajnyatvam, Alpashaktimatvam. And when there is total Tamas in there, then we call Tamah Pradhanam. Tamas is Pradhanam. We call that Prakriti as Jagat. So Jiva, Jagat and Ishwar, all of these are from the standpoint of Upadhi. And all of these are nothing but the manifestation of same Prakriti. In all of them, only one Chaitanya is the Adhishthanam. This is how the Vyavastha is explained by Panchadashi. Understand, all of these are ways of explaining Vyavasthas, you know. And therefore, don't hang on to things. Because else we will find a slightly different prakriya, so don't get upset about it. So that means we are not in every way the same as Hiranyagarbha. Hiranyagarbha's upadhi is Vishuddha Sattva Pradhana. The Jiva upadhi is Malina Sattva Pradhana. And therefore, from the standpoint of upadhi, there is a tremendous difference. A big difference is there. From the standpoint of upadhi, there is a big difference. And that's what counts today. What counts today is upadhi, and therefore, that difference today counts, you know. He is great. He is omniscient, omnipotent, omnipresent. And who am I? I am insignificant. So, from the standpoint of upadhi, there is a great difference. Of course, from the swarupa is the same. Upadhigata ashuddhi bahulyat samsaritvameva. Again, that full stop should not be there. Samsaritmaiva prayashah abhilapyade. So, the jiva is generally described as samsari. Rarely is described as jivan mukta. Then it's not samsari. So, now and then you do find shrutis and smritis also describing jiva also as param. In a rare case, manushyanam sahasreshu or bahunam janmanamante. So, jivas are rare among many. And Hiranyagarbha is usually described as omniscient, as para. Then Anandagiri says, Katham tarhi tattvamasi kshetrajnyam chabhimam vidhi ityadi shruti shrutivadaha sangachyante. Exactly. So that one Shruti says, tattvamasi, you are Brahma. Kshetrajnyam chabhimam vidhi. Gita says that I am the kshetrajnya of the self in all the beings. Ityadi shruti smritivadaha sangachyante katham. How do we reconcile with this? Tatraha vyavrutta iti, says Bhashyakara. Vyavrutta krishnopadi bheda pekshayatu sarvah paratvena vidhiyate shruti smritivadaihi. Vyavrutta krishna upadhi bheda apekshayatu. However, apekshaya, from the apeksha or from the standpoint of vyavrutta krishna upadhi bheda. Upadhi bheda, all the bheda or the duality or divisions which are created by the upadhi. So vyavrutta, when all of these are denied or negated, one has grown out of them. Or one has overcome or transcended all the dualities created by the upadhi. Tad apekshayatu. Then, from that standpoint, in that state, sarvaha paratvena abhidiyate. Sarvaha jivaha apekshaya alochana, he says, okay. So by the alochana or by the knowledge of recognizing oneself as devoid of all the upadhi. Sarva hai jiva hai, all the jiva paratvena abhidhyate. There was a statement, tattvamasi applies to everyone. And kshetrajnam chabhimam vidhi applies to everyone. Not that it applies to some enlightened jiva alone, it applies to everyone. And how does it apply? Vyavritta krishna upadhi bheda apekshaya. So when the jiva does the alochana, he does reflect upon his true nature, which is devoid of all the upadhi, then the statement tattvamasi or kshetrajnam chabhimam vidhi is definitely applicable to every jiva, and in that sense, every jiva is described or called as none other than Paramatma. So this is how the position is of the Vedanta, that we find this apparently contradictory descriptions of Hiranyagarbha, of the jiva, of course you find now and then, but of Hiranyagarbha, and they have to be reconciled in this manner, that there is always going to be some limitation, some little blemish in upadhi, because otherwise upadhi cannot be. Upadhi can never be free from some blemish. Therefore, they just want to show that even Hiranyagarbha also has some blemish, that's all. That's why the mother, after giving birth to the child and everything else, will put one little dot here. Yeah, one dot. That there's nothing perfect. That at the level of manifestation, there's going to be some imperfection. Therefore, in our Puranas, Itihas, are also, all the great people are also described all right. I mean, there can be none greater than them. As far as their accomplishments are concerned, then still you find something somewhere. Just to show that at the level of upadhi, some blemish can always be there. And therefore also Hiranyagarbha is described here as possessed of fear or arati, is not swabhavika, not even befitting of the upadhi, generally speaking. It is that in the upadhi, some blemish can also. So Bhashyakara is not bothered about it. He has dealt with it in this manner. This is how Vashyakara has dealt with this bhaya and arati. That if this Shruti seems to describe bhaya and arati in case of Prajapati, it is only to describe the samsaritvam, meaning that upadhi has some limitation. So they always want to make sure that you understand that upadhi can never be limitless. And that the limitlessness always is from the swabha, is the swarupa, and never at the level of upadhi. And now even Prajapati also, none other than Prajapati also is not free from that little blemish. I guess this is how Bhashyakara looks upon these passages of Bhaya and the Arati. He doesn't go into further great detail that Sureshwaracharya did, because it's all risky ground anyway. But that is what the Acharyas do. Because otherwise, how do you understand the life? Life has to be proper. It's one thing to always live in and dwell in an imaginary world or a world of idealism. It's another thing to find a world as it is real. And one has to deal with it and one has to understand it. If you deal with it or not, it's a different thing. But at least you understand it, you know. And therefore, the Acharyas have to spend time to understand that. That is how Sureshwara Acharya has dwelt at it at length there. Okay. Now, continuing. Swamate tattva nischayatva muktva nischaya muktva paramate tat abhavamaha. This also is necessary. So mandanam and khandanam also. Then okay, you are also right and they are also right. No, that's not so. Just because we say this doesn't mean that they are also right. Abhavyanam asmin varadaramaniyam aramanim vihantum vyakroshim vidadhata ihaike jadadiyah. So all these jadadiyahs are never accepted, you know. Because they always want to do the ninda. They want to use their buddhi to do the ninda. Atar kyaishwarye tvai anavasthaha dura anavasthaha hatadiyaha kutarkaha. This kutarka takes this hatadiyaha. Kutarkoyam kamsit mukharayati mohaya jagataha. This kutarka is able to take this fellow, hold of these fellows, this hatadiyaha, the fellows with buddhi is because of the kutarka. Those fellows with buddhi is really, you know, is afflicted. Kutarga takes this fellow's buddhi and makes them say all kinds of things to confuse the people. So when these fellows make all kinds of arguments to confuse, it's not they who are doing it. Kutarga is doing it. So Kutarga we don't accept. And that also point must be made. The point must be made that Kutarga is not accepted. So, Swamate Tattvanishyam Uktva What is Tattva Nishchaya? Meaning, how do you understand the Shruti in the Smriti? His own opinion has been given. Paramate tad abhava nishchaya tattva nishchaya abhavamaha. But when you go to Mata of the opinion of other fellows, you find an absence of Tattva Nishchaya. This is also what Bhashyakara wants to make clear. Tarkikaistu. So is Bhashyakara. Tarkikaistu. Parityakta. Agam balaihi asti nasti karta akarta ityadi viruddham bahutarkayadbhi akuli kritah shastrartah tena arthanischayo durlabah. Tarkika is, everybody else is Tarkika. Other than those who follow the Shruti as Pramanam, so only those who accept Shruti as Pramanam, meaning the Vedantins, everybody else is Tarkika. Whether Tarkikas are particular school of thought, alright, but it is not only that they alone have arrived at their conclusion through Tarka, everybody else has arrived at their conclusion through Tarka alone, because we don't accept any other Pramanam. That your experience can be Pramanam, that Vedantins don't accept. That Buddha may have an experience and other people may have an experience, and from that experience they have stated what they did, that is not accepted. Either there is Shruti or there is Tarka. Because naturally, when the Shruti is not there, a given experience is explained by Tarka or by reasoning. So everybody is called Tarkika. Parityakta Agama Balaihi. Those people who do not enjoy the strength of Agama. Agama means the Vedas. Those who do not enjoy the strength of the Vedas, and therefore those whose strength is purely based upon Tarka or the reasoning. There is an explanation in the footnote in the Mahesh research book there, which says, Parityakta Agama Balaihi Vedadeva Padarthan Nirupayatum Anichchadbhi Yuktyaeva Prapancham Nirupayatbhi. And this is a fascination that no one can overcome. Vedadeva Padarthan Nirupayatum Anichchadbhi. Those people who are not desirous of merely accepting the conclusions of the Vedas, meaning to ascertain the nature of a thing, merely accepting Vedas as a pramanam for ascertaining the nature of the tattva, those people who are not desirous of that, yuktya eva prapancham nirupayadbhi, those people who are desirous of ascertaining the truth of the world, truth of the life by yukti or by reasoning. And there is no exception to this. I was reading the other day Tolstoy, you know. All these are very great thinkers. But they said truth is something that always is always in a flux, meaning it always is discovered. You can't say that he has the highest regard for Jesus Christ, he was a great Christian. And his book was written for presenting Christianity properly, and how the church and all of them are totally corrupted it and confused it in what it is for their own ends. So this was the whole idea of the book. You know, the kingdom of heaven is within you. But even there also, where he accepts Jesus Christ's teaching as a pure teaching and that what must be implemented in life, and he goes to the extent of saying that everything, all armies and police force and courts must be disbanded because this has no place in Christianity at all. Because love thy neighbor as you love thyself, and therefore everything must be solved by love and not by force, and any agencies therefore who are bringing about, want to settle the issue by force, must be all disbanded. All armies must be first disbanded. These armies are nothing but all these fellows who are mad, the generals and the fellows, or the rulers. Those fellows who have created a band of other mad people. That's all there is. Intoxicated and mad, and who can only accept one, you know, command, and who cannot think of anything else, they have created these robots. That's what they have done. And this one set of robots fighting, this is how, and that's all reality. This is all fact. So according to him, this is not Christianity. And although these fellows who are in the name of Christianity justifying wars, the church also, they are all wrong. So this was his whole contention. But then also, he says that you cannot arrive at this when you structure the Christianity, or when you structure, that means that you have arrived at a conclusion, and that is not acceptable. the truth always, the understanding grows. Understanding of truth always grows. It can never be final. And therefore, to accept one understanding as final is not right.
So, yuktyaeva prapancham, prapancham nirupayat bhi.
So, this position that we have is purely orthodox position. That Vedas are the pramana is an orthodox position. And nobody will accept that position because yuktyaeva prapancham nirupayat bhi. Those people who are desirous of ascertaining the nature of the truth by yukti and not by accepting what somebody said. Whoever it is, doesn't matter who it is, who says doesn't count. Whether your rishis are there or whoever it is, yuktya eva prapancham nirupad, what is it? Nirupad bhi, those fellows who are only desirous of ascertaining things by their own intellect. Therefore, they do not enjoy the strength of the pramanam or the Vedas, the agama. And therefore, they arrive at all this kind. Therefore, asti nasti. Asti and nasti. Asti means thiraha, atma iti vaisheshikadeha. There are many. Other than sunyavadis and kshanika vijnanis, everybody else accepts atma as asti, meaning thiraha, as a permanent entity. Nasti kshanika jnana samudayaha eva atma iti buddha. The buddha asti, or the vaisheshika asti, the atma is not there. Or the kshanika vijnanin say the atma is asthiraha. So, sthira atma asti, sthira atma nasti. That there is a lasting atma or atma who is a lasting substratum, and there are others who say, no, such an adhisthanam is not there. Kshanika vijnana samudha, kshanika jnana samudha eva atma iti bauddha. So, the bauddha, the kshanika vijnanin says that atma is nothing but a samudha, a flow of the momentary consciousness. Sthiraha karta iti, karta and akarta, of the fellows who accept that atma is. First of all, there are people who don't accept atma. Now the fellows who accept atma, they are also karta. Iti vaisheshikaha nayayikaha. Vaisheshikas nayayikaha say that atma is karta or a doer. Akarta. Iti sankhyaha yogascha. The sankhya and the yogi say that atma is akarta. Asti iti karta iti cha nayayikaha, that atma is a karta, is nayayika. Nasti iti bauddha tarkikaha, that atma is not there, is the buddhas. So these are all tarkikas, all these various tarkikas are there, and they arrive at asti nasti, karta akarta, akarta ityadi, viruddham bahut tarkayat bhi. So all these fellows, tarkikaihi nirmolot preksha matrena tattva nirnaye pravruttaihi. This is tarkikaihi. Those fellows who are only desirous of arriving at the nishchaya, tattva nishchaya by tarka. Tarkayat bhi akuli kritaha shastrataha. Footnote number 6. Akuli kritaha. Tarka pravyukta nishchaya vishayatam apaditaha. Meaning is totally akuli kritaha, means totally confused. Or the translator is mystified. That is how everybody comes up with such wonderful things, you know, and words and so forth, that it all remains a mystery for everybody else. Or the Shastra, the meaning, what the Shastra wants to say is something that is totally confused or contradicted by this Tarkikas. Tarka prayukta nischaya vishadam apaditaha. That ultimately, they have brought down the truth only to the level of that which can be ascertained only by Tarka and not that which is revealed by the Shruti. This is how they have done it. Anandagiri says, Nanu eka jiva vadepi sarva vyavastha anupattehe tattva nishchedaur labhyam tulyam iti chet. Eka jiva vadepi, all right, when you say that, jiva is one, meaning chaitanyam, that is only one atma is. See, it is one thing to say that atma is one, sarva vyavastha anupattehe, but how do you explain the vyavastha? See, where the prakriya has come, where the shruti comes is, shruti reveals the truth, tattvamasi, aham brahmasmi, okay. But if I am tat, meaning I am brahma or I am limitless, how do you explain the fact that I am experiencing a sense of limitation? सर्वं खलु इदं ब्रह्मा ब्रह्मा इज वन अलोन और सदैव सौम्य इदमग्र आसीत एकमेव द्वितीयम इट इज वन एंड विदाउट अ सेकंड हाउ डू एक्सप्लेन द ड्युअलिटी हाउ डू एक्सप्लेन द डिविजन इफ यू कैनॉट एक्सप्लेन दैट देन द ट्रूथ विल ओनली रिमेन डिक्लेरेशन समथिंग दैट अवर बुद्धि कैनॉट कॉम्प्रिहेंड और अपार्ट फ्रॉम बुद्धि नॉट बीइंग एबल टू कॉम्प्रिहेंड there are so many questions in the buddhi that our buddhi will not be able to proceed even to comprehend the truth because it is totally confused by its present experiences and therefore what the shruti reveals seems to totally contradict what we experience and therefore there is a need to explain our experiences that is called prakriya prakriya means a model that gives or seeks to give an explanation of our experiences One experience is that I am a limited being. Other experience is that I am a conscious being and the world is inert. A third experience is that I am different and everybody else is different. Fourth experience is that I am seeking something and that when I get something that is desirable, I feel happy. And all these experiences are there. Each one of these experiences seem to contradict what the Shruti says that you are Ananda. That doesn't seem to be my experience. And therefore, there has to be an understanding of our experiences. Such that that understanding is consistent with or in reconciliation with what the Shruti reveals and then alone we can understand okay this is all right that I feel limited yeah okay I understand that the world appears different I understand that there is this division I understand when you understand at least that no more remains a botheration or it no more remains an obstacle to your comprehension of truth So our present experiences and conclusions are the obstacles in comprehending the truth, nothing else. What we have at the moment concluded, that conclusion itself becomes, you know, just pulls me down every time. Even though you want to comprehend the idea that I am limitless, every time that thing that I am, how can you say you are limitless? How can your mind say, how can it be? You know, that Brahma alone is everything, how can it be? I don't see Brahma anywhere naturally. I see all sin everywhere, anyaya, all kinds of things and suffering. How can you say Brahma is everywhere? And therefore, all these things which are there in the mind, they always come and question this or do not allow our mind able to abide in this. Even though momentarily things may be all very clear, immediately these problems come and unsettle the mind. Therefore, how to settle the mind? Only when we are able to understand our experiences in keeping with what the Shruti reveals, then the duality is also all right in spite of the fact that truth is non-dual. The sense of limitation also is understandable even though you are limitless. And everything is okay, is understandable, everything makes sense. When everything makes sense, then alone we can go ahead of this world and samsara. Otherwise, we cannot proceed further. That's a bottleneck. That's a chain in our, you know, in our legs. Our feet are tied with the chain and we cannot proceed. That's all. You try and you are pulled back every time. And this is a struggle. Therefore, all these prakriyas are given. All of prakriya means all of these explanations of life are given. Which is what we call Anukula Chintanam. All the prakriyas are arrived at by the teachers based on what the Shruti reveals. Shruti herself gives some prakriyas also. But then many prakriyas and all these terminologies are arrived at in order to explain what the Shruti says. And that is the case with every tradition by the way. Every tradition is like that. The Bible says something. He just declares all kinds of things, you know, in his own world. And then the Bible may be only this much. And the explanation of Bibles will go on, you know, volumes and volumes will go on and on. Because how do you understand what he says? Based on what we find and what we are. And what should we do? And so all of these naturally require an understanding and a settlement in our mind. This is called Vyavastha. So this is explanation of Vyavastha. That's all. He says, if you say that Atma is one and limitless and non-dual, then how do you explain the life where we experience duality and multiplicity and limitation? So this is the Purupaksha here. Nanu Eka Jeeva Vadevi Sarva Vyavastha Anupattehe. If you accept Atma as one, how do you explain the Vyavastha or how do you reconcile with the the life where there is multiplicity. Tattva nishche daurlabhyam tulyam. Therefore, even by you also, unless that truth of oneness of the, you know, the oneness of the of Brahman or oneness of the Lord, unless that can explain our life, tattva nishche daurlabhyam tulyam. So you also will not be able to arrive at the ascertainment about the truth. So they also cannot arrive at because they are dependent upon tarka. And you also cannot arrive at because you can't explain life also. So tattva nishche daurlabhyam tulyam. Wherein them and you, the problem is the same, that you cannot, whatever be the reason, but you cannot arrive at the ascertained understanding or comprehension of truth. Na ityaha. Yeto iti, says Vashyakara. Yeto kevala shastra anusarinaha shantadarpaha tesham pratyaksha vishaya iva nischitaha shastrartha devatadi vishayaha. Shastrartha is Paramatma. The footnote number 1 says, Tena, footnote number 2 says, Nirmula Shushka Tarkena. That is already we read. Tena Artha Nishchaya Durlabha Yetu Keval Shastram Sarinaha. Those on the other hand who purely follow the scriptures, and that is tough. When is it possible? Shanta Darpaha. Only when that intellectual arrogance that one has of being able to understand, explain, you know, as long as that is there, that darpa, that arrogance is there. Shanta darpaha. Not those fellows who are frustrated or disappointed. Shanta darpaha. Those people who become humble. So what happens is that when we give up our arrogance, we get broken down. That's the problem. Like that, what do you call it? That palm tree, either it stands like erect or it breaks down. No. Either we stand erect, meaning that we apply our intellect everywhere and don't accept anything, or when we find that intellect cannot explain, we get so frustrated, so then also become totally dejected. Shanta darpaha. Those people who recognize that this is the darpa or arrogance, that I seek to be able to understand everything merely by my intellect without the help of the Shruti, then when one understands that yes, intellect is required, in order to understand the Shruti and then in order to understand the life, you definitely require the intellect. And that one understands the place of the mind, the place of reasoning. So Shanta Darpaha meaning those who are free from arrogance. Not free from thinking or free from applying their mind. They are not free from that. So those people who understand the place of the intellect or the place of reasoning as it is, and those who have properly ascertained the place of the scriptures, this is what we call Shanta Darpaha. Otherwise, if you are hurt, then you will not be able to apply your reasoning at all, which also is not right. If you are arrogant, then you don't accept the Vedas as Pramanam. If you are totally hurt, then you become incapable of using your mind to understand what they say. Therefore, here you are not hurt, nor you are arrogant. See, everywhere there has to be Viveka, everywhere. And so, Shanta Darpaha, Vashyakara, how beautifully, because when it comes to this Tarka, the only thing that really requires us and makes us project our two cents is only that darpa, nothing else. At the same time, it's not there, but just because my two cents are not there, therefore I don't think at all, you know, that also is not right. So Shanta Darpaha says footnote number 3 also is done anyway, that's okay. Footnote number 4, Shastra Pratikula Tarkarahityam Kaivalyam. So, Shastra Pratikula Tarkarahityam. Not Tarkarahityam, but Shastra Pratikula Tarkarahityam. Where one is happily able to give up Pratikula Tarka, that's all. All that one is required here is not merely to swallow what the Shastra says, or not trying to understand what the Shastra says, but merely give up the Pratikula Tarka. Don't be obstinate about it. Then you will find that what Shastra, you will be able to recognize the truth of what the Shastra says, provided first you provide the Anukula Tarka. So Shastra Pratikula Tarkarahityam, that's all that is accepted, that is all that is expected out of the student is that he gives up the Pratikula Tarka, that's all.
సిక్స్ ఫుట్ నోట్ నెంబర్ ఫైవ్ తర్కోద్భావక విద్యాది ప్రయుక్త మదరాహిత్యం శాంత దర్పత్వం తర్క ఉద్భావక విద్య దట్ విద్య ఆర్ దట్ ఐఎమ్ ఎ విద్వాన్ దట్ ఐఎమ్ ఎ లెర్నెడ్ పర్సన్ దట్ ఐ కెన్ ఆల్సో థింక్ అండ్ దట్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ థింకింగ్ అబౌట్ మీ ఓన్లీ మేక్స్ మీ ప్రెజెంట్ ఇన్ నియర్ తర్క తర్క ఉద్భావక సో దట్ విచ్ యాక్చువల్లీ క్రియేట్స్ ఎ తర్క ఫ్రమ్ మీ ఈజ్ మై ప్రైడ్ దట్ ఐఎమ్ ఎ లెర్నెడ్ పర్సన్ ఐ కెన్ ఆల్సో థింక్ యు నో So I also can think, and that's what makes me present new tarkas. So tarka udbhavaka vidyadi, and there can be some other kind of arrogance also, for other than vidya also. So vidyadi prayukta madrahityam. That madha or the arrogance or the intoxication that one has on account of either vidya or account of anything else, it can be kulam, it can be vittam, it can be anything. And that when one becomes free from that arrogance, that is called శాంతదర్పత్వం శాంతదర్ప తేషాం ప్రత్యక్ష విషయ ఇవ ప్రత్యక్ష ఇస్ ఘటాదివత్ భాష్యకర సేస్ ఫర్ దెమ్ ద ట్రూత్ ఈస్ యాజ్ క్లియర్ యాజ్ ఘట దట్ ఈస్ హిస్ నిశ్చయ హిస్ ఓన్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ ఈస్ ఘటాదివత్ దోస్ పీపుల్ హూ ఆర్ శాంతదర్ప ఫర్ దెమ్ ద ట్రూత్ ఈస్ ఘటా యాజ్ క్లియర్ ప్రత్యక్ష విషయ జస్ట్ యాజ్ యూ సీ అ పాట్ సో క్లియర్లీ ఆల్సో యూ కెన్ సీ ద ట్రూత్ శాస్త్రార్థ దేవతాది విషయ శాస్త్రైగమ్య దేవతాది రూపో విషయ ప్రమేయ ఇత్యర్థ మీనింగ్ ద ఐడియా ఇస్ శాస్త్రార్థ మీనింగ్ శాస్త్రైగమ్య దేవతాది విషయ విషయం ఇస్ ప్రమేయ దట్ టు నో అబౌట్ దేవత మీనింగ్ అబౌట్ గాడ్ విచ్ ఈస్ శాస్త్రైగమ్య దట్ ఈస్ విచ్ కెన్ బి ఓన్లీ నోన్ త్రూ ద శాస్త్ర ఫార్ దట్ సో దట్ ది నాలెడ్జ్ ఆఫ్ ది ట్రూ ద లార్డ్ which can only be gained through the Shastra, that becomes very clear to the people whose arrogance has been quieted and therefore who accept Shruti as a Pramanam, giving up only Pratikula Tarka and employing Anukula Tarka as necessary for them, this becomes very clear. So they say here, the truth has to be seen by the Buddhi, that's all. Shastra is the eyes that we have, and all we have to do is, we have to make our Buddhi also tuned up or aligned with the Shastra. And the way that we can see through the eyes of the Shastra is merely by giving up Pratikula Tarka. And by applying where necessary Anukula Tarka. That's how our own Buddhi also can be aligned with the Buddhi vision of the Shastra. And you can see the truth as clearly as the Shastra sees. This is how the idea is. Sri Anandagiri స్వప్నవత్ ప్రబోధాత్ ప్రాగ్ అశేష వ్యవస్థ దీస్ ఆల్ క్వశ్చన్స్ ఫ్రమ్ వార్తిక ఐఎమ్ ష్యూర్ దట్ హౌ ది వ్యవస్థ వార్తికారం మస్ట్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ స్వప్నవత్ ప్రబోధాత్ ప్రాగ్ అశేష వ్యవస్థ సంభవాత్ సో వెల్ వెన్ యు ఆర్ అవేక్ యు ఆర్ వన్ అలోన్ బట్ వెన్ యు ఆర్ డ్రీమింగ్ యూ బికమ్ మెనీ సో హౌ ది ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ ది ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఆఫ్ డ్రీమ్ కెన్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ ద మెనీనెస్ ఆల్సో ఇన్ వన్ స్వప్నవత్ ప్రబోధాత్ ప్రాగ్ బిఫోర్ యు ఆర్ అవేక్ స్వప్నవత్ వెన్ యు ఆర్ ఇన్ డ్రీమ్ అశేష వ్యవస్థ సంభవా ఆల్ ద డ్యువాలిటీ ద వ్యవస్థ ఆఫ్ ది సబ్జెక్ట్ అండ్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్ అండ్ సుఖ అండ్ దుఃఖ అండ్ ఆల్ దీస్ థింగ్స్ ఆర్ దేర్ ఇన్ స్వప్న ఈవెన్ దో దే ఆర్ నాట్ దేర్ ఇన్ రియాలిటీ అండ్ దెర్ఫోర్ ద డ్యువాలిటీ అండ్ ద సంసార విచ్ ఇస్ నాట్ దేర్ ఇన్ రియాలిటీ కెన్ వెరీ వెల్ బి దేర్ హౌ కెన్ ఇట్ బి యాజ్ ఇన్ స్వప్న మీనింగ్ హౌ ద మైండ్ కెన్ ప్రొజెక్ట్ ఇట్ అండ్ దెర్ఫోర్ ఆల్ ది సంసార కెన్ వెరీ వెల్ బి అండర్స్టూడ్ as we understand the dream and therefore there is no difficulty in explaining the experiences that we have urdvam cha tadhavasti ishtatva at the same time when you wake up from the dream then it is quite only right that there is no samsara that was there in the dream which also is proper the samsara also is all right that there is no samsara also is all right samsara is okay when there is dream there is projection of the mind there is no samsara in your own true nature when you wake up Therefore, both of them are right. Right means they are all right. They can be understood. Ishtatvat ekameva brahma anadi avidyavashat ashesha vyavaharaspadam idipakshe na kachana dosha kala idi bhavaha. And therefore, ekameva brahma, one brahma alone, anadi avidyavashat, on account of avidya or ignorance which is beginningless, అశేష వ్యవహారాస్పదం
Brahma alone becomes the aspada or the locus of all the vyavahara of manyness and oneness.
Iti paksha na kachana bodh dosha kala iti bhavaha.
In this paksha that we have, there is no dosha at all. So this way we can explain how one Brahma alone can become the locus of all kinds of contradictory vyavahara because of projection of the mind, and that there is no vyavahara when the projection is not there. Therefore, this very well explains the vyavastha. Therefore, we have no problem. We who accept the Shruti as a pramanam, and we who provide the anukula tarka, we have no difficulty at all in seeing the truth that the Shruti reveals. But those people who are not in that category will never be able to see that.
Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Vajrayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmedi Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyomavat Vyapta Dehaya Dakshinamurtaye Namaha Om.